So let's talk a little bit about pelvic organs and their relationship to low back pain. You can see here an image from Netter showing you the endopelvic fascia. We have the bladder here, the cervix, so the uterus has been removed, the colon, the rectum here, and you can see this layer, this continuous layer of fascia that surrounds all of these organs, connecting from the pubic bone all the way to the sacrum. And in this image from Paoletti, you can see the same, the uterosacral ligament. Uterosacral ligament attaching around the base of the uterus and to the sacrum. This endopelvic fascia is continuous with the presacral fascia, which covers mostly the entire sacrum. It's usually between S2 and S4, but it could go all the way from S1 to S5. Jean-Pierre Barral and Gail Wetzler did a study on 36 women, pelvic pain for a mean 3.7 years. They randomly divided the two groups into two groups of 18. Group A, they did functional testing on all the people to get a sense of where their immobilities were and their problems were with functional testing. In group A, they received visceral manipulation. In group B, they received joint mobilization over the specific joints that were the least mobile. In group A, they received the visceral manipulation over the specific organs within the pelvis that were the least mobile, that had the most restriction in them. And it just so happened that most of them were in and around the uterus. Group A had better outcomes in all of the reassessment of functional tests. And this is the VAS before and after. Group A, the VM group, the visceral manipulation group, their VAS pre-treatment was 6.9. Group B was 6.7. And then 1 month follow-up, it went down to 1.8 versus 4.1. The change for the visceral manipulation group was 5.1 versus 2.6 in the joint mobilization group. So if the restriction, if the low back pain is coming from the pelvic organs, then it's the pelvic organs that have to be mobilized or the tension's released. Most of the treatments that were done on these women were between the uterus and the bladder, between the uterus and the broad ligament to either side, which attaches to the ilium between the AIIS and the pectineal line, so really kind of covering the whole lower pelvic floor, and also between the uterosacral ligament. In this case, it's one of my own cases, 48-year-old woman, 9 years of low back pain, constant, severe, not able to resolve it no matter what she's done. She had 13 years of severe bladder incontinence as well, which I thought was interesting. This is why she was coming to see me, for the bladder incontinence, and a second-degree cystocele. A cystocele is the bladder pushing into the anterior wall of the vagina. She had a history of a severe injury to her coccyx and L5 vertebra, and that's where they believed all of her low back pain was coming from. And she just sort of lived with it. She had 9 years of it and figured that nothing was going to change. Her occupation was as a potter, so she spent all day just kind of hunched over around her potter's wheel. Her VAS before treatment was 6 on a 1 to 10 scale. I treated. My general listening went into the anterior pelvic cavity, and I worked with her uterus, which sits right here, in relationship to her uterosacral ligament, which wraps around the uterus and attaches again back to the entire presacral fascia. I worked with the pubovesical ligament. These are the pubovesical ligaments here. So I worked with the one on the right. It all was right-sided. And the articulation between the uterus and the bladder. There was an adhesion between the uterus and the bladder. After the first treatment, she had, at day 15 after the treatment, a 15-day follow-up, her back pain went down to 40%, which was not why she actually came in to see me, but her back pain went down to 40%. Her cystocele, which she felt as a pressure in her pelvis, was still there after the first treatment, but she no longer felt the pressure, and her incontinence was significantly improved. And she felt that she had better control over her Kegel contractions, whereas before she said she couldn't even feel them.